गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज के संतोष कुमार, पीजीटी जूलॉजी श्रीकाकुलम। वेलकम टू अवर यूट्यूब क्लास। वी आर कंडक्टिंग द यूट्यूब क्लास फॉर एमसेट एंड जूलॉजी, एंड वी विल डिस्कस सेकंड ईयर जूलॉजी टॉपिक डाइजेशन एंड एब्जॉर्प्शन। सो लास्ट डे एंड बिफोर लास्ट डे वी सी दैट ऑल द पार्ट्स आर इन्वॉल्वड इन द डाइजेशन। Already you know that mouth, different type of the teeth, tongue. Okay, today our topic is pharynx. Okay, pharynx is a muscular organ. What kind of organ it is? Muscular organ. So oral cavity leads to the short pharynx. It is a common passage. It is a muscular chambers serves as a common passage of food and air. It is a muscular chamber and it is a common passage of the food and air. Then it divides into three parts: nasopharynx, oropharynx, and laryngopharynx by the soft palate. Okay, nasopharynx lies above the soft palate. The oropharynx present in the middle of part, and laryngopharynx. This is the part is present in lower, so it is a lower part. So the esophagus and the trachea, opens into laryngopharynx. So these mainly the trachea opens into laryngopharynx through by the glottis. So glottis, we have to find the glottis. It is a split like opening over on the pharynx. Okay, and this glottis have contained some cartilage flap. This that is called epiglottis. It is called epiglottis. So this epiglottis which helps in the preventing of entry of the food particles into trachea at the time of swallowing. Okay, the pharynx possesses a important muscles that is called voluntary muscles. Then it is useful for the swallowing of food materials. Okay, then this pharynx have contains the so important structures that is called tonsils. These are also called as the lymphoid tissues. Okay, present in pharynx. This can be divided into three main types. Okay, pharyngeal tonsils or adenoids, palatine tonsils, it's having one pair, and third one lingual tonsils, which having one pair. Okay, these are all about the pharynx. So these pharynx is opens into long tube like structure which is connects the pharynx center and stomach, that is called esophagus. So esophagus is a long muscular tube connected the pharynx and stomach. The anterior part of esophagus is connected to pharynx. The posterior part of esophagus is connected to stomach. Then coming about the esophagus. Okay. Then coming to esophagus. Already you know that it is a long tube like structure connected to pharynx and stomach. Okay, thin long tube which extended posteriorly passing. It's extended posteriorly passing through the neck, thorax and diaphragm. Okay, neck, thorax and diaphragm. And finally it leads to stomach. And when these esophagus finally leads into the stomach, then a muscular splinter regulates the opening of the esophagus into stomach. Okay, muscular splinter is regulates the okay it regulates the opening of esophagus into the opening of stomach. That is called gastroesophageal splinter. Okay, gastroesophageal splinter. Okay, that is about the esophagus. Then coming to stomach. Stomach, it is a wide J-shaped. It's a wide J-shaped distensible muscular bag-like structure. It is a wide J-shaped distensible muscular bag-like structure. And it is located in the upper side portion of the abdominal cavity, just below the diaphragm. Upper left portion of the abdominal cavity, just below the diaphragm. Okay, then when we have to see that it's a divided into three main parts. The stomach is divided into three portions or three parts: cardiac stomach, fundus stomach, pyloric stomach. Cardiac stomach, fundus stomach, and pyloric stomach. The pyloric stomach is opens into the duodenum. It is the first part of it is a superior portion of the duodenum. Then this pyloric stomach opens into the duodenum. This is the first part of small intestine. Okay, when the stomach is opens into the duodenum, we have to find the small muscular sphincter, that is called pyloric sphincter. Pyloric sphincter. Then coming to that another part in alimentary canal, small intestine. So this is the longest part of the alimentary canal. This is the longest part of the alimentary canal. And we have to find serially these small intestine serially divides into three main parts. Okay. Proximal duodenum. This is the first part of the small intestine. Proximal duodenum. And the second part is a long coiled jejunum. It is a long coiled jejunum. And the finally distance. Okay. Distensible. It's a distal highly coiled part. This is the distal. Distal highly coiled ileum. So the three main regions are found in the small intestine: duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. It is a proximal duodenum, and the second part is a long coiled jejunum, and finally this distal highly coiled ileum. Okay, then it opens into the another part, large intestine. Okay, you want to more videos from me. You like my video, share my video to your friends, and mainly subscribe my channel. Thank you all of you.